Welcome everybody to another episode or another tutorial. In this one we'll talk about how to create this bend effect and bend texture flip fluid simulation that is falling on this glass made letters. And as you can notice, there is sheen coating and some subsurface scattering on the bend. So hopefully you will enjoy this tutorial. This is another preview. Multiple color, and as you can see, they are mixing to create different color also when they meet side each other. Also, you are welcome to join my Patreon page on Fadi VFX, where I put all of my scene file, my projects, my experiment, examples, tutorial, and many more. And also here we can talk and discuss and develop ideas, help each other in this community. So waiting for you to join me there and support me, which will be very much appreciated. And now let's go to the HIP file. So this is my scene file. Here I have a couple of cameras pointing at the object with the multiple view. Here I'm just keeping the frame range that I want to render. A background. The background is just a grid that I applied bend to it and subdivided more, so we have some transparent smooth angle, and I transform it in a proper position. Here I'm exporting my text. This is the text. You can add any text you want. Here I am selecting all the open edges. Then I give it a little bevel, as you can see here. Also, I added thickness to it, so it's hollow from the inside. Convert it to VDB, then convert it back to polygon. So this is the shape. We have nice fillet or bevel. I give it the extensive color. Added some UV and a material. This is the UV. So I can add texture to it later on, like smudge or fingerprint, so the glass won't look clean. Now to the main file. Here all these parts are the source for the flip fluid, as you can see, and they are moving sideways, different speed, and they are continuously emitting fluid. We'll just take one of them, like this tube. We put it in position, as you can see here. Then we add some transformation, and this transformation by a channel. That's referencing this channel. After that, I'm creating a surface flip fluid source, and I'm keeping the voxel size connected to the flip solver, but I remove the shell thickness. With this one, it will extend. This is the particle separation, some jittering, and oversampling, all set up by the flip fluid. After that, I give it extensive or special color that will be carried out all through the flip fluid, so I can differentiate between each one of them. And here, as you can see, I created an channel override that's being referenced up here in the motion effects. So all these 27 fluid source, they have their own different wave motion. As you can see, this one, each one has its own amplitude and own decay rate and period. So we have different view. Okay. And here I can view them all while they are moving. After that, all of these flip fluid sources are added to the DOB network. Let's go to the DOB network and have a look. So as you can see here, cell is creating the first frame. Just give it a second. Okay, now we are live. So each one of these objects that we see here are referenced here, the out surface, and the source is particle, and the volume is surface, and the activation I keep it one. I was playing with it on and off, but then I decided to keep it as one. All of these are merged together here to the flip fluid solver at the sourcing input. On the other hand, we have the flip fluid object connected to the first input, and here I added some drag 0.5 so the fluid will not run smooth. Here I was experimenting with adding some friction and dynamic friction and dragging, but I disabled them. Also the behavior to stick also, because there's a better way to do it. So in the flip object initial data, I added viscosity, so it's activated here, and density I kept it 1000, and here I kept it 0 because I will control it in the flip solver. So in the flip solver, get the sub step the same particle motion behavior. I add ID attribute and age particle, and use friction and bounce. So whatever I add here will be affected. Also whatever I add here in the physical will be included. Preceding I kept it on. Here I didn't do anything, but in the volume motion, this is the volume of the container. Collision, here I enabled stick on collision, and the stick scale I kept it 0.8. if it's higher, it will look like rubber, so that's why I kept it like this, so not all of it will stick. The distance I kept it low, 0.05, maximum cell of 1, and the bias 0.6. if it's 1, all of it will stick. Less than 0.5, going to 0, none of it will stick. So I kept it at 1, and I keep the scaling of the tangent and the normal as 1. Viscosity is enabled, as we enable it here, as you remember, in the flip object. Now in the flip solver, you need to enable it and use the attribute, and I increase it to 2. Static object, I give it little bit bounce. Instead of 0.5, I make it 0.07, and decrease the forward, and the friction I make it only 2. The ground I didn't change any, I kept it the default. After that, there's a gravity, and we sim out. This for a previous experimentation. Now here, I imported the fluid, then I compress it. It's being compressed now to save it as a file cache, and this is here where I can preview it. Let's go to frame 29, frame 60, and this is the fluid. Frame 90. So this is one of the frames. After that, I went from the compressed cache to unpack it. So now it's unpacked. And from here, I went down to the name from a group, because each one has its own group, as you can see here. Each one has its own group. How it's being activated, let's go to the first frame and go inside the dubnet. Here in the instance, not in the instance, here, where is it? Ah, stream name. See, this is where it will export the group name for this one. This one 25, this one 24. So each one has its own group that's been recognized. See, these are the groups. So I'm adding the particle fluid surface. I only connected the particle separation to the flip fluid particle separation, and the influence scale I increase it to 2, and I activated the dilation and erosion. Also the smoothing to be mean curvature flow, and the final smoothing to be mean value. Just take one of the frames, give it a second. Maybe I better go to the caching. No, one second, I'll go here, and this is what we have. Now here I don't have color or only name, so I'm transferring the attribute of the CD. The CD I brought it from here, because I have no this method I was trying with, but I change it. How I went with it, this is not needed. I went to the first node, I call it color, and I choose which, let's just take a color and show you. So this color I added here. Now the one I want to choose is on points, so I'm choosing from points. Here I press 9, and according to the, not the connectivity, sorry, to the groups. Which one I choose? Attribute, ah, name. See, by name. So each one, each streams, like if I choose this one, this one, this one, this one, and this one, press enter. Now if I give it a color, let's say red, now this will be red. I change it to green, now they are green. Then I move to the next one, I added another color, a third one. So I added as much color as I want, all the way down, so I'm not constrained by the coloring that is being received upstream. And the mesh is still connected as one. So if I stop here and render, you will see these patches in this area, and they are very ugly. So best way to do it is to blur this value, because this value is just an attribute on the point. So I want to average it out, so it's being blurred with its surrounding. So I used attribute blur and I increase it to 100 with a step size of 1 only to run on the CD. So this is how it will look. See, much better. Compare. See, look like Chinese letter somehow. Then I added material and I render it out. Now let's talk about the materials. No, before the material, one thing. Here is the text extruded. I added some of the edges to be extruded out a little bit, so when the paint go flow around it to give it the proper shape. I scatter, I give it a fracture, so it will be in the collision much nicer. There is no concave body for the curve or the hollow parts. Here I was thinking when the paint go beside the glass that it will stain it with its color. So best way to do it is to import the by using a solver. Inside the solver I'm importing the previous frame color, I make it black as you can see, and the second input is the paint, and I'm transferring the attribute of the color with zero distance threshold, but I keep the blend width very low. I transfer it out, but I didn't carry out this procedure, but it's being cached, and you can do it. Here I'm blasting, I'm keeping the result. I think I delete it, and extruding it and smoothing it, but no need. Let's talk about the material. Here, this is the background material, nothing fancy. This I didn't use, basically I didn't use the glass. The glass, I keep the index of refraction 1.6 with high roughness, so it's not clear glass, with high reflectivity, something in the middle, and transparency I kept it at 0.95, with some distance of 0.2, the depth that will the rays will go in, and some dispersion of 0.05. And for the paint I used as a wax with index of fraction of 2 with very shiny specular, transparency 0.3 with the increased distance because it's a thick paint, and I added subsurface scattering at 1 with the distance of 0.19 with a random walk for the karma, because I'm rendering in karma with little tiny 0.1 sheen, and the triple S will be using the point color. And this one for the background, I forget for what. Anyway, for the output I use karma XPU path tracing at 128, and I increase the triple S subsurface scattering and the reflection and the refraction. I'm just rendering as a JPEG. Image output, the filter I use denoising. Also I use where is it, render camera effect, I add motion blur is turned on, and I enable the depth of field. So let's say, let's take one of the cameras, this one. If you press Z you will see the depth of field, this one, and you can control where the focus will be, or you can right click and focus handle, it's Z. And that's it. So hopefully you enjoy it, and you are welcome to join my Patreon page where you will support me so I can upgrade and improve to add more heavy and complex material, because my computer is old age now, it's dying now, so I must upgrade it. So anyway, have a nice day, and thank you very much.